I am Dr. Schudel and I will present an overview on glomerulonephritis. The learning objective is to understand the clinical manifestations of glomerular diseases and diagnostic features, as well as to know the differential diagnosis of glomerular diseases. The outline will be as follows. 1. Clinical manifestation and diagnosis. 2. Differential diagnosis and their characteristics. 3. Therapy. Glomerulonephritis is a major cause of chronic kidney disease. It is characterized by inflammation of the glomeruli, which alters the filtration barrier. This leads to proteinuria and often to hematuria and impaired kidney function. The clinical presentation of glomerulonephritis may vary from asymptomatic urinary abnormalities to nephrotic or nephritic syndrome, rapidly progressive glomerulonephritis, or chronic glomerulonephritis. The hallmark of nephrotic syndrome is heavy proteinuria, which is usually caused by podocyte injury. Nephritic syndrome is characterized by hematuria, some proteinuria, and subsequently renal failure. This is due to endothelial injury and increasing inflammation, leading to proliferation with rapidly progressive glomerulonephritis. Clinical symptoms of glomerular injury may include oliguria, edema, hypertension, and renal failure. Due to the altered filtration barrier, proteins, red blood cell casts, and dysmorphic red blood cells may be present in the urine. Serum analysis for complement, various antibodies, and anti-streptolysin O titers can give important clues for the diagnosis. However, most diagnoses require a kidney biopsy. Minimal change disease is defined by a normal light microscopy and normal immunofluorescence, but characteristic fusion of epithelial food processes on electron microscopy. In children, the disease is usually idiopathic and glucocorticoid sensitive and has an excellent prognosis. In the elderly, association with drugs and lymphoproliferative disorders is important. Membranous nephropathy is the most common cause of nephrotic syndrome in adults. Recently, antibodies against antiphospholipase A2 receptors on podocytes have been described in the idiopathic form, which makes an autoimmune origin probable. Secondary forms are associated with malignancies and infections. Subepithelial immune complex deposits in the basement membrane cause the pathognomonic immunohistochemic appearance. Focal segmental glomerulosclerosis manifests with proteinuria. Histopathology shows caring in some glomeruli, which refers to as focal. Manifestation occurs in only some segments of the glomerular tuft, which refers to as segmental. Etiologies are primary idiopathic, genetic, associated with viral infections, drugs, or reduced nephron mass with hyperfiltration, for example in reflux nephropathy or renal dysplasia. Membrana proliferative glomerulonephritis is also a descriptive term of a histopathologic entity. Underlying causes are infections, neoplasms, or systemic lupus erythematosus. The histopathologic changes consist of hypercellularity and the characteristic double layers of the basement membrane due to interposition of mesangial cells through immune complex deposits. Immunoglobulin A nephropathy is the most common form of primary glomerulonephritis worldwide. Immunofluorescence reveals IgA in the mesangium of all glomeruli. The pathogenesis is still poorly understood, but an association with upper respiratory and gastrointestinal infections is frequent. While in IgA nephropathy, hematuria follows soon after upper respiratory tract infection, onset of the acute post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis is typically 10 to 20 days after pharyngeal or cutaneous infection. Because of the delay, the etiologic microorganism cannot always be identified, but high antistreptolysin O titers together with the characteristically low complement can confirm the diagnosis. The disease mostly affects children and in majority of cases shows a spontaneous recovery after the acute episode, while IgA nephropathy more often is a chronic disease. ANCA vasculitis often affects glomerular and alveolar capillaries, hence the term pulmonary renal syndrome. The mediating antineutrophilic cytoplasmic antibody are circulating in blood but are rare in glomerular stainings. Therefore, it is also named posi-immune glomerulonephritis. The diagnosis of Goodpasture syndrome is made by the detection of antiglomerular basement membrane antibodies and crescentic glomerulonephritis with a typical linear deposition of the autoantibodies along the glomerular basement membrane. The antibodies are directed against the alpha-3 chain of type 4 collagen, which is also found in basement membrane of the alveoli. Therefore, concomitant alveolar hemorrhage occurs in the majority of cases. There are more systemic diseases which can cause glomerular injury. Diabetes mellitus is common and characterized by diffuse hyalinization and nodular glomerulosclerosis. Renal amyloidosis occurs in patients with multiple myeloma or with chronic inflammatory disease. Congo red stain is diagnostic. Immune complex deposition in systemic vasculitis, like systemic lupus, can cause proliferative glomerulonephritis. If possible, the first step of therapy is the treatment of the underlying causes. Meanwhile, symptomatic treatment is important to minimize complications. Immunologic disorders are treated with immunosuppressive drugs like corticosteroids or cyclophosphamide. Rapidly progressive glomerulonephritis may improve with plasmapheresis. This table summarizes the most important glomerular diseases with their clinical characteristics.